The things that inspired me to study science at university was I was always a very inquisitive child and I always just wanted to know how things worked. And what's been great about this is when you do a job in science, you never need to stop learning. I've always found the environment of the science faculty, being a woman, to be very supportive. I've certainly never noticed any differences because of my gender. I've never found any problems because of my gender. And in fact, I feel on a day-to-day basis, I'm just treated as a scientist, which is essentially what I am. The challenges that I've faced have been more to do with my science rather than to do with who I am. It's more about what I do. I think that the atmosphere is hopefully changing to be able to encourage women to become involved in the sciences. I still think we've got quite a long way to go. However, certainly within the university, there are things in place to be able to support people in the early parts of their career, and I think that's where it really matters to women. And to make sure that they get the encouragement to go forward and to become future world leaders in science. I mean, the ways on a personal level that I like to encourage potential future scientists is I like to do schools outreach. So I've spent the last week going into schools. I've talked to 1,500 school kids over the last 5 days and tell them why it's cool to be a scientist, what's fun about doing science, what makes me get out of bed every morning. And hopefully, even if it only gets through to a few of them, if we can encourage students who may not have considered doing science, and this particularly actually I think applies to girls when they're at school, if we can encourage them and show that science is great, science is fun, and that, you know, hopefully they can see that women do science and women have great careers in science, then it might spark something in them that encourages them to go on and maybe think about a career in science as well. I think early career support is really, really important for all scientists, but I guess it has a special place when you're thinking about supporting women's careers. Certainly within the Department of Physics recently, we've put together an early careers forum, which I'm very much involved in. And the idea is that we meet and we talk about issues to do with teaching, research, things that we can all share and experiences that we've all had, which mean that we can learn from each other. And then we have one coherent voice to be able to go and talk to people, maybe in higher up in the department, in the faculty, and share our concerns and actually do something practical and positive. This year, quite unusually, we've got a first year training course. It's the Bristol Centre for Functional Nanomaterials first year training course for the PhD programme. It's our doctoral training centre. And we've got a cohort of 10 students, of which 5 are female students and 5 are male students. So it's fantastic actually to see that kind of gender balance coming through. And it's really the sort of thing that I hope we'll see becoming more and more normal as we go on. Recruiting students, that we're bringing in the best female students that we can.